continue our talking about the lesson, I would like to say thank you for all people who stayed at home now for safety because of the coronavirus. I miss you so much and also miss our school, but inshallah we will soon meet and continue our work. We had finished our talking about the sensation of plants, and we started our talking about the sensation of humans. From our previous session, all of you knows that the nervous system and the endocrine system are the two systems which control the sensation of human beings. We also talked about the building and structural unit of the nervous system, which is the nerve cell or the neuron. There are three types of nerve cells. The first type is the sensory nerve cell or sensory neuron. Sensory neuron transmit the nerve impulses from the receptor organs to the central nervous system. The second type is the motor neurons, which transmit the nerve impulses from the central nervous system to the effector or responding organ, such as muscles and glands. Number three, or the third type, is the connector or intermediate neurons, which relay the nerve impulses from the sensory and the motor neurons, which means they connect between the sensory and the motor neurons. Now we will talk about how the nerve impulse is transmitted through the nerves. Please concentrate and keep attention. Before talking about the transmission of the nerve impulse through the nerve, we must know the nature of the nerve impulse. The nature of the nerve impulse is the electrochemical phenomenon, or it's an electrical phenomenon with a chemical nature. Electrical phenomenon with a chemical nature. So it's an electrical or electrochemical phenomenon. What is the nerve impulse? The nerve impulse is a message that is transmitted through the nerves from the sense organs to the effector organ, or from the receptors to the responding organ. Also, to understand the nature of the nerve impulse and its transmission, we have to study the changes that occur on it during the following four conditions. Now we will talk about the first state, or the nerve cell at rest. Nerve cell at rest, it means before stimulation. It means in the normal state. This is the nerve fiber membrane, and we notice outside the cell membrane and inside the cell membrane. When we study the ions concentration outside and inside the nerve cell membrane, it was found that the concentration of the sodium ions outside the cell is from 10 to 15 times higher than its concentration inside the cell. But the concentration of the potassium ions inside the cell is 30 times higher than the concentration in the fluid that surrounds the cell. The concentration of the negative ions inside the cell is greater than its concentration outside the cell. Sometimes they ask it to give reason for this concentration. This is due to the presence of chloride ions and protein ions. And all of you knows that the protein ions have high molecular weight. So the inner membrane, the inner surface of the cell, is negatively charged, and the outer surface of the cell is positively charged. The unequal distribution of the ions results in the presence of an electrical potential difference called resting potential. This resting potential equals negative 70 millivolt, resulting in the polarization state. Now we will talk about what's meant by polarization state. The polarization state is the state of the nerve cell at rest. When its outer surface is positively charged and the inner one is negatively charged. So now what are the reasons for the occurrence of polarization state in the nerve cell? There are three reasons for this polarization state. Number one is the unequal selective permeability of resting membrane to sodium and potassium ions, because this membrane is highly permeable for the potassium ions. So the positive potassium ions, which concentrated inside the membrane, started to penetrate the membrane and comes outside it with the sodium. The second reason is the accumulation of high molecular weight protein ions. The third reason is the sodium-potassium pumps that present in the fiber membrane. This makes the potential difference of cell at rest reaches negative 70 millivolts. Now we will talk about the second state, the changes that occur on stimulating the nerve cell. The nerve cell is stimulated only when the stimulus is sufficient. There are also changes that occur in the permeability of the cell membrane to ions. This led to inflow of large amounts of sodium ions to inside the cell and outflow of small amounts of potassium ions to outside the cell. This makes the amount of positive charge that enters the cell is enough to neutralize the negative ions inside it. This means the outer surface becomes negatively charged, and this is the reverse of the resting state. The membrane potential difference becomes about positive 40 millivolts, and this new state is called depolarization state. So the depolarization state is the state of the nerve cell on stimulation. So it doesn't take place except on stimulation. When its outer surface is negatively charged and the inner surface is positively charged. Now we will talk about the third state. The third state talks about the propagation of the nerve impulse through the nerve fibers. The depolarized point act as a stimulus for the neighboring point of the nerve fiber membrane, which undergoes the same previously changes that occurs on stimulating the nerve cell in the first time. The nerve impulse is propagated along the nerve fiber in the form of waves of depolarization, polarization, and then depolarization again. As soon as the end of the stimulus effect, we reach the fourth state. It's the return of the nerve cell to its original state. It's called repolarization state. There are changes occur in the nerve fiber membrane as follows. Number one, the nerve fiber membrane becomes again permeable to potassium ions and impermeable to sodium ions. Number two, the nerve fiber membrane returns to its previous permeability before stimulation, at rest. Number three, the unequal distribution of ions returns also to its original state. It returns to polarization. It means repolarization. Number four, occurrence of refractory period, in which the membrane of the nerve cell restores its physiological properties to be ready to respond to a new stimulus and transmit another nerve impulse. The refractory period is a short period of time, 0.001 to 0.003 of seconds. Follow the nerve stimulation, in which the nerve cell membrane restores its physiological properties to be ready for responding to a new stimulus and transmitting another nerve impulse. And during this period, the nerve will not respond to any stimulus, whatever its strength. Number five, the The response of nerve cell to the stimulus is called the action potential, which includes a state of depolarization followed by repolarization, and it equals 110 millivolt. The action potential is the phenomenon of depolarization from negative 70 millivolt to positive 40 millivolt, then followed by repolarization, negative 70 millivolt, and it equals 110 millivolt. Number six, the motivation is the propagation of action potential rapidly along the nerve cell. Let us talk about the properties of the nerve impulse. The first property is the speed of the nerve impulse. It depends on the diameter of the nerve fiber. How does the nerve impulse depend on the diameter of the nerve fiber? This is because in the thick myelinated nerve fibers, the speed of propagation reaches 140 meters per second in the large diameters. But in the thin non-myelinated nerve fibers, the speed of the propagation reaches 12 meters per second. So this is in the small diameters. The second property, all or none law. This means that stimulation of nerve and muscle contraction obey the all or none law. What is the meaning of all or one law or none law? This means that the nerve will not respond with a maximal strength unless the stimulus is strong enough to stimulate the nerve. Any increase in the stimulus will not increase the response strength. This means that the weak stimulus is insufficient to change the nerve cell from rest state, negative 70 millivolt, to action potential, 110 millivolt. If you look at the figure, you notice the presence of special areas or sites present between the neurons. These areas are known as synapses. We can define the synapse as the site that present between terminal arborizations of the axon of one neuron and the dendrites of the next neuron. There are three types of synapse. Number one, the synapse between two neurons. Number two, synapse between a neuron and a muscle fiber. Number three, synapse between a neuron and glandular cells. Let us see the structure of the synapse. If you return to the figure again to see the structure of the synapse, you will notice that it consists of main three parts. Number one, the synaptic knobs or buttons. Synaptic knobs or buttons are swelling that present at the end of the terminal arborization, and they are located very close to the dendrites of the next neuron. The second part is the synaptic vesicle. Synaptic vesicles are small sacs present inside the buttons and filled with chemical transmitters or chemical substance known as neurotransmitters, such as acetylcholine and noradrenaline. These chemicals play an important role in the transmission of the nerve impulse through the synapse. The last part is the synaptic cleft. Synaptic cleft is a narrow space between the buttons and dendrites of the next neuron and separate the presynaptic membrane from the postsynaptic membrane. What is the mechanism of transmitting the nerve impulse across the synapse? This takes place through steps. When the nerve impulse reaches to the button or synaptic knobs, this leads to the entrance of the calcium ions inside the cell. This inflow of calcium ions led to the rupture of large number of synaptic vesicles and relays of chemical transmitters from them. The chemical transmitters cross the synaptic cleft and reach to the dendrites membrane of the next neuron. The chemical transmitters bind to their special receptors to the dendrites membrane, and this led to the stimulation of these points and change the permeability membrane of the sodium and potassium ions. This results in their depolarization and production of an action potential, which propagated from the nerve cell body to its axon, and then to the next neuron, and so on. After performing its function, acetylcholine is destroyed by the effect of a special enzyme called cholinesterase enzyme to terminate or to finish its action. Therefore, the postsynaptic membrane in the dendrites returns to the polarization state again. At the end of our lesson, all of you knows how the nerve impulse is transmitted through the nerve fiber, the properties of the nerve impulse, and also the mechanism of transmitting nerve impulse across the synapse. I wish you to understand the lesson, and don't hesitate to contact if you need any help or answer of any question. Thank you and goodbye. See you in the next lesson.